Come on, 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 come on Welcome to today's KMEA. This is the Baja High School Principal, Paolo Barnes. The Colonial Interscholastic Federation and its member schools have made a commitment to promote good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators at all KMEA section events. Profanity, degrading remarks, and intimidating actions directed at officials, competitors, or other spectators will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from any event site. Spectators are not allowed to enter the competition area prior to, during, or after the conclusion of the contest. Violators are subject to removal from the venue. Thank you for your cooperation and the promotion of good sportsmanship at today's event.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to tonight's KIF Boys Varsity Volleyball Game between the Kauai Red Raiders and your Kapa'a Warriors! Now for the starting lineups for the Kauai Red Raiders, number 5, Aaron Giuliano. Number 6, Kai Potts. Number 7, Isaiah McCambra. Number 10, Zayn Valdez. Number 11, Isaac Myrie. Number 12, Cameron Hope. And number 14, Brian Brown. Now for the Kapa'a Warriors, number 1, Kyle Bouncer. Number 3, Austin Green. Number 6, Kalei Desanya Martin. Number 7, Steeler Burr.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to tonight's KIF volleyball varsity matchup between the Kauai Red Raiders and the Kapa'a Warriors. My name is Rod Green with my partner in crime, Christian Jenkins. How you doing tonight, Christian?
I'm doing good. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great. This is the first volleyball game of the season. This is our first volleyball broadcast, and I'm expecting some fun and theatrics tonight.
I am as well. Well, this is the first game of the season, so I know both teams are going to be trying to see what they can do with each other.
I'm excited about it. I think a couple of players to look out for, the outside hitter for Kapa'a, Kyle Bouncet, definitely one of the high flyers for Kapa'a.
Definitely a threat.
And then for Kauai, it'll be interesting. I'm not really familiar with their team. I know Brian Brown is a high flyer for them.
Yeah, we're familiar with Brian from basketball, and we know he can get off the ground and really put the ball down.
So it'll be interesting. We'll see. I see Christian Vito is in. He wasn't named as a starter, but I see he's in the game. So.
All right, a lot of basketball boys there for the
Isaiah Red Byrie, Raiders. Cameron Hodeho.
Yep.
For looks like only basketball players we have from Kapa'a is Austin Green and Emery Pitcherosity, both very good hitters. So starting it off will be Kapa'a.
Steeler Burley.
Wasn't happy with the first ball.
Nice floater.
And just like that, the Warriors are on the board.
That was a deceptive floater. I think the defense on that one, they weren't.
Yeah, you know, those float serves can be difficult because they don't have a steady flight pattern. Nice, easy jump float serve. And Red Raider is able to convert.
Serving for the Red Raiders is Isaac Mowry.
Isaac, ooh, a little too much mana on that serve.
Yeah, he had some power. He's one to watch with that power jump serve there.
Yeah, that's the thing.
I've seen him get it in warm-ups tonight, so it could be an advantage for the Red Raiders.
And bounce it with a nice, easy serve. Gets it in.
Ooh.
Nice block by Kauai Red Raiders.
Yes.
Oh.
Oh.
And the Raiders get the dink.
Hey, that was great hustle there by the Kapa'a Warriors, though. They were laying it all on the floor.
Oh, yeah.
They're a feisty bunch.
Steeler was going for the save, unable to capitalize on it. So Brian Brown will be serving for the Red Raiders.
Nice jump serve.
And he's going to be out.
Just a little bit long there by Brian Brown.
Hits it out.
And that's something we were talking about earlier, Rod, that high leaping ability of number 14, Brian Brown, with the Red Raiders.
He definitely gets up. So serving for Kapa'a is number 13, Lapella. Oh. And not enough mana, so unforced error with the serve.
Little floater right into the net.
So you'll notice there's a lot of substitutions that have come on, a lot of gamesmanship. For those that are new to volleyball, the libero is going to be the players on each team with the off-color jersey. And the libero,
wow,
when they come in as a substitute, as Kawhi comes with an ace.
That was a powerful serve by Holt.
Cameron Holt, yeah.
Powerful jump serve.
So when the liberos come in, the substitution doesn't count against the team. And after that ace, Holt follows it up with an unforced error.
Into the net.
So right now we got a 4-4 tie, Kapa'a Warriors and Kauai Red Raiders. Kapa'a Warriors in the home white jerseys. Austin Green serve for the Warriors. And nice kill by the Red Raiders.
Yeah. It was a nice set there by the setter. Put it right where he needed it.
So Zayden Valdez will be serving for the Red Raiders. And another unforced error.
Yeah.
That's the thing about the jump serves. I mean, it's
risk
and reward, you know?
Definitely.
High risk, high reward. Personally, I would rather just have the players get the ball in.
Right. Let them get into their offense.
Ooh.
Miscue by the Red Raiders there. Beautiful set.
Bounce set. Goes for the dink instead of the kill.
Austin Green for the kill. I think there was a touch. No? Oh. It looked like there was a touch.
Red Raiders, 6-5 lead.
Vito serving.
Christian Vito, he's a pretty good basketball player too.
Yeah, he is. He's a pretty good point guard. We watched a lot
Red
of him.
Raiders, yep.
And another
unforced error
into the net.
Not sure if it's nerves so far.
I don't know. We didn't see a lot of that in the JV game. They were getting it over the net.
So Kamale Desayamunding will serve it up.
Good serve. Received by Vito.
At the tip by the Warriors. Still a Burley.
Green going up.
And Green with the kill.
Green with the kill. First kill of the year for Austin Green.
Nice.
Another basketball player.
Yep. Nice set by Steeler Burley.
Yeah, we both know how important that setter is, and it looks like Burley has come to play today. He's had some nice sets today.
Yep. Desalia is one of the better servers for Kapa. Ho going for it. Oh, Felici.
Oh, good save by Felici.
Save. And Desayamunding unable to save it. Great attempt, though.
Great attempt. Especially with that powerful shot there by Brian Brown. Not only can he jump, he has some power behind his hips.
Yeah, Munden is one of the more athletic players on this team, too. You'll see him, and that's why he's a libero. He's flying all over the place. He will go and die for every ball.
Yeah, he'll lose some skin on the court tonight. Definitely.
So Giuliano will be serving for the Red Raiders.
Got a free ball. Burley with the set to Green. Nice block there by Brown. Ooh.
And a Red Raiders score.
Yeah, I thought that was going to be a definite kill for Van Svet there. Just a miss hit.
So Giuliano will be serving again for Red Raiders.
Nice little floater. A lot of movement on that serve.
See with the pass, the set to bounce it, and he gets the kill.
If he gets a nice set, Rod, he's going to drill it every single time. He has tremendous leaping ability.
Yeah, he hits. He's one of the few players that I've seen that actually hits the ball down.
Yes.
The trajectory is scary. Don't want to be in the way of that. Still a Burley with the serve.
Miss hit by Vito. Free ball for
free
the
ball.
Paw.
Oh. And Green can't convert.
A little wide. Reed has a heavy hand as well, Rod. You get him a good set, too. He can really drill it down.
Oh, yeah. He's another. That's the thing about the Warriors. They have a lot of great hitters. It's just a matter of converting. So Isaac Myrie serving for the Raiders. Oh, great save by Kyle Bouncett.
Free ball.
Great save by Burley. Felici Hunt unable to convert. He was going for it.
He was. Right into the net on that one, though.
And your timing, I mean, timing's got to be good in all your attacks, but it's really when you're in the back row, it's a little bit more difficult than having that set up in front, the front half.
He had a nice approach, though.
Yeah. And Isaac Myrie hits the second serve into the net.
And just like you said last time, Rod, the risk versus reward with that jump serve, that's the second time Myrie served it into the net.
Yep. So Kyle Bouncett, number one for the Kapa'a Warriors, will serve. Kapa'a down, 10-9.
Oh, miscommunication there with the
Raiders. A little bit long. It's going to be Red Raider point.
That was a close one.
Yeah, just a little bit too long. Brian Browns serving for the Red Raiders.
Referee's looking at them.
It should be Kapa'a ball. It looks like the block.
No.
Looks like they're going to give it to the Red Raiders. I thought the ball went off of.
Yeah. That was a nice set there. That should have been a kill by Felici. He usually nails that. Vito with the quick hit.
Also with a nice save. And a free ball for the Red Raiders. And it's going to be out by Vito. Serving for the Warriors, Mapella. Okuahi.
I believe he's a football player.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You can see the size.
And he's one of the comedians for the team.
Oh, miss hit. Free ball.
Free ball for the Warriors. Let's see if they can get a good set.
Beautiful set.
And Felici, once again, unable to
connect. Yeah, he's having a rough start here, Rod. Yeah, I think that's the third one into the net there for Felici.
It looked like a decent left set.
It was a decent set. He had a nice approach to it. Might be a little tight opening night. Nice serve by Holt. Oh. Powerful jump serve there.
Powerful jump serve, yeah.
Well, he has some height on him, too. I think this one's coming right back to Felici, number 15 with the Warriors. You better be ready for this one.
Another great serve.
Yes.
Curran Pope unable to convert.
Yeah.
Warriors might think about taking a timeout here, and sure enough,
they do.
Red Raiders go up 15-10.
We've got a pretty good game going here so far, Rod.
Yeah, it is. Definitely a good game.
So far, it looks like we're hurting ourselves. We've had a lot of hitting errors so far this first set. Hopefully we can clean that up.
Yeah, and the Red Raiders, they've had some unforced errors on their serves, but we haven't been able to capitalize on it. So I think once they settle down and just play their game, there's going to be nerves on both sides.
Oh, but, definitely. This is a great feel-out game for the start of the season here.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a real competitive KIF volleyball season.
Yeah. I think there's going to be a lot of parity, as we were talking about earlier.
Yeah, I think, well, as you see, these two teams are going at it. Waimea, they've got some players, and then also
Island School.
You can definitely count on Island School with some of the players they have. So
it's going to be an interesting year.
All right, so out of the timeout, the Red Raiders will serve Cameron Ho-Ho. Just like that. That's why a lot of times those timeouts are good.
It freezes them.
Yep.
We use those in basketball all the time.
So right now you got Miles Green coming in for Austin Green.
Distant cousins.
Yep. So Miles will serve. I love Miles Green's energy. He's definitely an energy guy.
Yeah, he's definitely a spark coming off the bench there.
Gets a good serve. And it's going to be out.
Alcambra, a little long on that one.
A little long, yep.
Oh, signaling a tip there.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Valdez back to serve for the Red Raiders.
That's the thing about this game. It moves so fast. The slightest things you might miss.
That is true.
Especially for us back down the stage. There. Oh, Curran Pope with the kill. Nice one hitter.
Yeah, he was quick off the ground with that one.
Nice set by Steeler Burley.
Mm-hmm.
So Felici Hunt
back to serve here. Good serve by Hunt.
Oh, great save by Tasaya Munden.
Oh.
And the Warriors are fortunate to get that point.
The dreaded beams up there.
For those of you watching at home, if the ball hits the beams, it is legal.
It's a live ball.
Live ball regardless. However, if it hits the antenna, then it's out, and obviously if it hits the net, it goes into the net, it's a dead ball as well, unless it goes over. Felici Hunt with a nice, and Kyle Bonson with a powerful kill.
Beautiful set there by Steeler to set up that kill there. It was right on the money, right where he wanted it. A good setter will make your whole team.
Totally.
Make life a lot easier for you.
Felici, looks like he was aiming for Brian Brown. Nice block, Curran Pope. Desaya Munden with the nice, looks like a double hit.
Yep.
And Steeler Burley with the dump.
Nice
I love that little dump by the setters. To every now and then,
it
keeps the defense on their toes.
You can't use it all the time, but keep them on their toes. Keep them guessing every now and then.
Yep.
Hunt back to serve again.
Brian Brown. Oh,
there,
and he did
it
the dump again. The dump again. They're not looking for it.
No, and if they're not looking for it, keep hitting it.
Hit them where they ain't.
And that tied up the ball game here at 16 apiece.
I like how Felici Hunt is kind of looking at where he wants to serve the ball.
Definitely. Got to find that weak leak on the other side.
Got to get everybody involved. Hope with the block.
Yeah.
Cameron Ho-Ho. And unforced error by Christian Vito as he hits it in the net. So Kapa'a able to take a 17-16 lead. Felici Hunt on a roll with his serves.
Yeah, Vito hit it right into the middle of the net there. Nice roll here for Hunt. Nice serve.
Oh,
there you go.
Another. Pope is on fire.
Yeah, he's active.
Yeah,
he's active.
He is. And, you know, he just recently started to play.
Yeah.
Middle blocker.
He's quick off the ground, though, and that's what you need for a middle blocker. You got to have someone that can get off the ground and can get off the ground quickly.
Yes. So Kapa'a, 18-16-point lead.
Nice little run. Quick timeout by the Red Raiders to try and slow this down.
And a lot of times, yeah, the coaches will call that timeout to not only settle their team, but if the other team is on fire with the serve, try to get that server out of their rhythm.
Try and ice them a little bit.
Yeah. Which you see that in basketball for free throws. You see it in football for kickers trying to kick a field goal.
Yep. It's a tactic used in all sports.
Yeah.
Felici having a nice run here at the serving line.
Let's see if he can maintain. And he continues to serve well. Bounce it. And Pope with the double block.
Yeah. They both get off the ground quickly, so that's a formidable blocking duo right there.
Yeah, it is.
Hunt still serving for the...
And it looks like there's an issue with the scoreboard.
Again.
It's 19-16, but the scoreboard went out, at least the one that we're looking at. Oh!
That should be Red Raider ball.
Yeah. By the way, these are new scoreboards that they just... installed this week.
A few kinks to work out, yeah.
Apparently. Oh, now it's 0-0.
Oh, okay. All right, they might need to call a timeout here to get this scoreboard taken care of. There it is.
And just like that, they're going to call a timeout so they get the scoreboard squared away.
Yeah, Rod, we had some issues with the JV game as well. We had some malfunctions with the scoreboard.
And I like the leadership that I've seen right now. Kapa, they know that the scoreboard needs to be fixed. So Kyle Bouncett rallied the team together. Go over a couple of tactics. And I think we got everything back in order. 19-17 is the correct score.
One of the phrases we like to use in our basketball broadcast, it looks like we got a barn burner today.
Yep, we got a barn burner, yep. And this is only the first one. Man, it's going to be out.
A little long by Vito.
I just saw Cameron Holt-Hole and one other player do like a little dance prior to the serve. You might want to wait till after the set for that. But.
Yeah.
But whatever gets you motivated.
That's right.
So serving for Kapa'a, Kasaya Munden.
We might have a free ball here for the Warriors. Burley with a nice.
Oh, bounce it.
Yeah, he got
nice
it.
Nice kill.
I'm liking where Steeler Burley is leaving the ball tonight, Rod. He's had some success setting. He's leaving it right there in a good spot for the hitters to just bang away.
Yeah, and hitters love that.
They definitely do. Free ball for the Warriors.
Ball. Oh.
A little long
Capella
there.
Mokwahi unable to convert. Serving for the Red Raiders, number 5, Aaron Giuliano.
Red Raiders trying to stay close in this set.
Yeah, it's been a back and forth so far. Kapa started off pretty well, and then the Red Raiders took charge. And they were up by as many as 5 at one point.
Nice serve there. Had a lot of movement on it.
Free ball for the Red Raiders. Oh,
ooh, nice.
Green with a great save. Brian Brown with the roll hit.
Nice rally going here.
Very good rally. Free ball for the Warriors. And, another
nice
great save
dig.
After the one. The Pella goes for it again.
That
another
a beautiful
save
dig,
by the Raiders.
Rod. Hoy.
Ho hits it out. What a great rally.
Yes.
The best rally of the night.
A little long there by Holt Ho.
They, looks like they gave.
Oh.
They gave that point to the Red Raiders.
I think there was a touch there by the Warriors.
Once again, I didn't see it, but
I didn't either.
Who am I?
We got a pretty good view too.
So Giuliano serving again.
Looks like the referees are discussing something here. Here we go.
Ooh. Miles hits it in the back.
Yeah, lower part of the net there, too.
Yeah.
Didn't like the approach on that shot, Ron. He needed to gather his feet a little bit more before he went up. I think he was a little off balance.
Yeah, the approach is so important when you're going for your kills.
Nice dig there. Right back to him.
Point, Red Raiders.
Yeah, I'm waiting for Kyle Bamset to get hot here. We know he can get hot. See, he struggled here early in the first set. Ooh, mishandle there. Green. Free ball for the Warriors.
Set to Felici Hunt. Hey, Kyle Bunsett
go, Kyle.
With a nice kill.
We were waiting for a Kyle Bunsett kill.
So Green in for Green. So still a Burley. The setter will be serving for Kapa as they have a 22-21 lead. Go for the jump float serve. Cameron Ho-Ho, and he hits it long.
Yeah, a little long by Ho-Ho. He's winding up and really trying to power that ball down there, but not so much control yet. Timeout. Kapa 23, Red Raiders 21. Well, Ron, we got a tight back-and-forth game. We had Red Raiders start out hot. Kapa got hot. Back to the Raiders, back to Kapa. I think it's going to be a long night. Long
it
night of volleyball.
Looks that way, yeah. Very competitive first set.
We'd like it to be a three-set sweep, but it looks like we might be in for a little bonus of volleyball tonight.
Yeah, we'll take it one set at a time, see what we got. Burley will be serving once again for the Warriors. Oh,
nice
Cameron
kill
Ho-Ho
there
with the kill. Felici Hunt unable to get to it. Very well placed kill.
Yeah, it looks like Cameron Ho-Ho was actually coming down on that hit, but he still got it to fall. Nice kill.
So here's Isaac Myrie serving for the Red Raiders. He's been inconsistent so far. We'll see what he does.
With that powerful jump serve. Hit or miss.
And oh.
And that was a hit.
Definitely. So Felici Hunt with the shank.
Got a tie ball game here. Timeout. Kapa.
So Kapa's going to call a timeout.
Yeah, they want to talk over a few things.
And I think this may be to ice. Isaac.
It might. But so far in this ball game, Isaac Myrie, he's had a an ace, and then he's follows it up with a hit to the net.
Error,
yeah, unforced error. So that's what we're anticipating here. Good timeout by the Kapa Warriors. Still serving for the Red Raiders.
Oh,
nice serve.
Great serve by Myrie.
That one was heading towards the line, too.
Yeah, it was. So,
Aloha ball here for the Red Wolf Raiders.
And the first team to 25 wins the set, and it has to be by 2 points.
And he serves it a little long there.
So Kyle Bouncett will be serving for the Warriors.
I just saved my partner from getting hit in the face.
I thought I saved you. Quick reaction up here. Definitely an alliance then. Bouncett able to get the serve in.
He's coming to hold hole. Nice block there.
Giuliano going to be a free ball.
Yep.
For the Warriors, see what they. Felici Hunt. And.
Yeah. Rod, he's been real inconsistent this first set. That's a lot of errors for Hunt. Look for him to bounce back, though. He's real resilient.
He is.
But I think that's 4-5 enforced errors into the net.
Well, once again, Raiders serving for Aloha ball.
Oh, nice to Green.
Oh, and Green can't convert.
Another unforced error by the Warriors.
So the Red Raiders win the first set 26-24. The teams will switch sides on the bench.
I think it's going to be back and forth like that, Rod, the whole night.
Well, I certainly hope so, considering we lost the first set.
Yeah.
I'm looking for the
nice
Warriors
bounce
to bounce back and do what they need to do.
Saw a lot of good things from the Warriors this first set, but we did have a lot of unforced errors, and we had a lot of serving errors. And if we clean that up a little bit, we should be ready to go in the second set.
Red Raiders definitely came out to play tonight. So.
So did we.
So as I mentioned earlier, each set, the first team to get to 25 by two, unless it comes to a fifth set, and at that point, it's the first team to reach 15 by two.
By two. Hopefully we can take care of this in four sets here.
That would be good. as the sweep is out of the question now.
Unfortunately.
And we definitely don't say that with any disrespect to any teams.
No, not at all.
The homer in us would like to see. But Kawhi has shown that they are an extremely formidable team, as all the teams in KIF typically are.
And to most of our listeners out there, I know you're familiar with Rod and myself broadcasting for girls and boys basketball, so this is our first time here with the boys volleyball. Give us a little bit of time to learn everybody's names in the league, and there might be a couple mispronunciations, but we'll get it together pretty quickly, folks.
Thanks for the disclaimer. I think we've been doing pretty good so far.
I think so.
So earlier I had kind of mentioned we got a comedian on the team, Napella Mokoahi. He's the senior for the Warriors.
Yes, he is.
So the team was on Oahu for a preseason tournament, and Napella dared the team to buy him something, and they said, okay, he says, whatever you guys buy, I'll wear it.
Brave young man.
Oh, my God. I came to practice one day, and it's unspeakable what he had on.
This is a PG-13
oh
broadcast.
Oh, my God. He had on short shorts that said daddy on them, and he had a halter top on. And his hair. But it's real fun that these guys, you know, are able to have fun like that and just do their thing. So.
They're real close. Good relationship amongst the team.
Yes, definitely. So we're going to start the second set. Kauai Red Raiders won the first set. 26-24.
Yes, sir.
Pa looking to bounce back.
Referee checking the rotations.
So starting it off, the second set will be the Red Raiders.
Giuliano back to serve.
And here we go.
Nice little floater.
And bouncing yes. with a nice kill.
That's what we need to get him going in the second set. Little inconsistent in the first.
And bounce it will follow it up by serving.
Little miscommunication there. Good dig there by Brian Brown.
Oh.
Oh, nice save there by Potts.
London with the save.
Aaron Green with the kill. Powerful kill there by Austin Green.
Great set.
Great set, great approach, great hit.
Yeah.
Get Austin Green going here a little bit.
And bounce it. That's it.
Myrie.
Felici with the kill.
Yeah, I think Felici needed to see that one go down.
Oh, he's another one that can get hot.
Yeah. He was a little inconsistent in the first set, but that might be what we need to get him going here.
Oh, yeah. So, Kapa'a Warriors off to a 3-0 start in the second set.
That looked like a double hit there by Holt Ho.
And free ball. Oh, and bounced it.
Yeah, missed it there.
So in for Potts is Zayden Valdez as Isaac Myrie gets ready to serve for the Red Raiders, number 11.
Great jump serve here by Myrie. Let's see if he can get it in. And he does.
Great serve.
Beautiful serve.
And Green with another kill.
Green gets his second kill of the set. He's starting to feel a little energized there.
And just like that, Potts comes right back in for Myrie.
And we have Pope in the game.
He did real well earlier.
Yeah, he did. Very active.
And Holt Ho with the unforced error hits a little long. So Warriors jumped out to a 5-1 lead.
Yeah, Rod, if Warriors score here, look for the Red Raiders to take a timeout here, try and stop some of this momentum.
Yeah, typically you don't want to get down by more than five before you call a timeout.
Right.
And
double
unforced
hit.
Error, Brown hits it into the net. So yeah. LaPella. Oh, looks like the refs are going to have a conversation. And I guess the Raiders wanted some clarity on something, and the refs want to confirm. And the point stands, so it's 6-1, Kapa'a Warriors.
LaPella to serve. Nice little float serve with movement.
Oh.
Miscommunication there with the Raiders.
Free ball for the Red Raiders. unable to capitalize.
Vito.
Warriors. Oh, Vito goes right at Nappella. Nappella tried to get out of the way.
He couldn't, right off his chest.
Use your hand, young man.
Vito's another one. He's not very tall, but he can get off the ground,
too.
He's got
a vertical on him, too, yeah. So serving for the Red Raiders, number 14, Brian Brown. And into the net. We saw Brian this year on the basketball team for the Red Raiders.
Yes, we did.
Very effective guard.
People might not know, for a small stature, he can actually dunk the ball with ease.
So, serving for the Warriors, Austin Green. And Brown hits it long.
A little long. Might be a timeout coming here quickly.
Yeah, I think they'll wait one more. Let's see.
Yeah, he's already talking to his other coaches there. Quick.
Oh,
there it is.
Going to be another point for the Warriors. And of course, there.
Yeah, Raiders a little out of sorts right now to start the second set here, Ron.
Yeah, especially considering how close back and forth that first set was. Raiders do seem a bit out of sorts. Green with the serve. Giuliano gets it over to Ho-Ho.
Another kill for Ho-Ho.
Yeah. And he'll set up for a serve. Ho-Ho with the jump serve. And he hits it long.
A lot of serving errors on both sides tonight, Rod.
Yes, it is. And you hate to see that as a coach.
You do, because it effectively takes your team out of.
Yeah, you have no chance.
You have no chance.
But like we said earlier, high risk, high reward. If he gets that serve in, it's money.
Definitely. Hunt back to serve.
Oh, great kill.
Yeah.
At number 7, Isaiah LaCambra.
Nice setup there by their big man, Ho-Ho, though.
Yeah, he's a pretty good setter, I'm noticing.
Yeah, he had some nice touch on that ball.
So Zayden Valdez will be serving for the Red Raiders, down 6 points, 10-4.
Nice
great
serve.
Great jump serve.
Yeah, a lot of power. Into the net there for Kyle Bansett.
Yeah. And I think, you know, as a hitter, as an outside hitter or opposite hitter, you have to really see where the ball is. Sometimes it's not high enough. So then you have to make the adjustment. You can't just swing away at every ball. Sometimes you have to make that adjustment.
You do. And sometimes you have to make that adjustment in the air. That's out of bounds.
So in for Pope is Nappella, Mokuahi, and serving for Kapa'a, Kamale Desalia Munden. And
a Red Raider ball. Little touch there. Raiders needed that one, Rod. This one's starting to get away from them a little bit.
Yeah, I agree, but 25 is a lot of points, so you're never really out of it. Bounce it, goes for the kill, and he gets it. Great job by Isaiah LaCambra to avoid the camera. That would have been disastrous for our Kapaa media.
Right. We're going to need some more kills like that from Kyle. Hopefully he sees a couple go down, and he'll start getting hot here. Still a little inconsistent.
Steeler Burley to serve. Oh, Brian Brown with the roll hit.
Yeah.
As opposed to the kill shot. And the Warriors, there's Kyle Bonsett again.
That's exactly what we're talking about. That's two in a row for him.
Great attack, great hit. 13-6, Warriors.
Steeler Burley still serving.
Oh, he goes to the opposite.
Yeah, a little miss hit there.
And the camera unable to convert.
Low set, miss hit.
So coming in for the Red Raiders for the first time is Caleb Schmeling. And he'll replace Isaiah LaCambra. Still a Burley. Another good serve. Brian Brown.
Nice block there.
Nice block. Free ball. And it's going to be out of there. The Warriors will take that 15-6.
I'm starting to get a little out of control. No timeout from the Raiders. Burley to continue to serve.
Man, a little bit too much.
A little too much power on that one.
And Dennis Fujimoto up on stage almost got hit with the quick hands to avoid that.
Yes, sir.
So just like that, Schmeling is out, and Giuliano replaces him.
That was a quick substitution.
Yeah, I know they want Giuliano in for serving.
Mm, definitely do. Miss hit there by Kyle.
It'll be a free ball for the Red Raiders. Oh, great shot.
Oh, out of bounds.
Oh, I think that was it. They called that out?
They called that out. That looked like it touched a little line to
me. Yeah, it looked like it was on a line. But once again, it's a very difficult task for these line judges.
It is.
And I don't envy that position.
Nice serve there by Alex.
Oh, and the Warriors able to get a quick one for Nabella.
Big fella able to get one over, huh?
Didn't seem like the timing was perfect, but hey, whatever works. So Alex will serve again for the Warriors. Nice serve.
Serve. Nice trajectory on that serve, Rod. Austin Green.
Oh.
Nice dig
Giuliano
there.
Giuliano able to do a nice dig. Brian Brown. Oh!
Oh.
Great rally.
Yeah, definitely. Substitution.
And the Raiders able to convert. So Alex will be replaced by Kyle Bonsic as Isaac Myrie comes back in to serve for the Red Raiders. Kapa'a Warriors 17. Kauai Red Raiders 8. If you're just joining us.
Nice serve there
Kauai.
By Myrie.
Oh, great save by Austin Green, but they're not able to convert. Kauai won the initial set, 26-24. And this is the best 3 out of 5.
Myrie's starting to get his jump serve down a lot, Rod. He's getting some good good heat, good movement on the ball.
Indeed he is.
Nice.
Great save by Felici. Nice roll hit by, oh.
Oh, nice save by the Raiders.
And Felici Hunt puts an end to that. And Curran Pope's going to come in for DeSalia London. Brian Brown for the outside hit. Nice. Oh.
Brian Brown with the kill.
Nice kill by Brown.
He has some explosion off the ground, Rod.
He really does. I'd say he's probably the most explosive.
Yeah, I'd agree
with
that.
For the Red Raiders, yeah. Holt Ho gets up there too, but he's got that natural height. But Brian Brown, he's getting up there. Oh.
That's an ace for Brian Brown.
And Felici Hunt, uncharacteristic of him, the shake.
Red Raiders going on a little roll here, Rod.
Well, 18-11, still got a nice 7-point lead. So, comfortable lead.
And oh, that's in.
A nice back nice. Row kill.
Yeah, I thought Red Raiders thought that was going to come over as a free ball, but no.
He just took it. He went for it.
He did. Got Austin Green back to serve.
Giuliano DeVito bounce it, and he cannot save it.
Nice kill for Vito.
So La Cabra will come in for Giuliano. As Cameron Holtholm will serve for the Kauai Red Raiders.
Nice jump serve.
And Polk with a nice attack hit. Oh.
That was
and the Red Raiders hit the net.
That was a great dig by
it was really a great dig.
Brian Brown, number 14 with the Raiders.
Unfortunately for the Raiders, they hit the net, so. And Lucy Hunt will be serving for the Warriors.
Comfortable lead.
Trying to even up this match as we lost the first set. Felicity Hunt has a real nice, quick, no-nonsense
right.
serve.
It has a little heat to it, has a little movement to it.
Yeah.
And it just it's barely over the net, too.
That's what really makes it difficult, I think. Certainly a level degree of difficulty in that.
Yes.
Green with the pass.
Kyle.
And Bounset. Oh, Desaya with the save. They give it back to Bounset. And he dumps it.
Nice dig by Holt Holt.
And Brian Brown rolls it right into the net.
Sometimes those easy ones are hard, Rod.
22-12.
Oh, got the first sighting of
Emery.
Emery
Pitcherosity will come in. He's another high flyer. Let's see how he does.
Another live arm.
Oh, he can really put it down, too. So.
Nice serve. I love that serve by Hunt.
Oh, great.
Dig by Hunt.
Oh. Green was going for the kill.
He was a
couple feet outside.
He had some bad intentions on that one.
He did. Zayden Valdez.
Back
to serve. The Raiders trying to get them somewhat back in this set as they're down 22-13.
Emery.
Oh.
Nice kill by Vito. Vito's getting a little active here, Rod, in the second set.
Yeah, he is. And I'd say they got one of their two best servers in right now. Kauai between Valdez and Cameron Holtholm.
Nice serve.
Oh. That was a poor set.
Yeah, it was.
Trying to get Pope involved. So your setter is kind of like the quarterback of the volleyball team. He's the one that dictates who gets the kill, who's going to go for your opposite or your outside hitter. Or
your middle.
The middle blocker, or if he's going to do a dump himself. So the Red Raiders with an unforced error. Going to put Kapa up 23-15, and Pope will come out being substituted by Napella.
We got Dasalia Munden to serve for the Kapa Warriors. Out of bounds.
So the Warriors will be going for Aloha Ball now.
This is the Warriors we're kind of expecting from the first set there, Rod.
I agree. Especially looking at the way the Red Raiders were warming up. They were hitting a lot of balls in the net early on.
They were.
I guess they got that out of their system.
You saw your Monday back to serve here. Aloha Ball, ladies and gentlemen.
Aloha. Hold hold with the set to Brown. It's going to be a free ball.
Yep.
Munden sets it. So, oh, and I didn't realize number 10 is in Isaiah Noguchi.
Yes.
This came up.
And
so
that is the game for the second set. DePaul with a, I'd say, a dominating win in that set, right?
Oh, 25-15, definitely dominating victory. So Kapaa able to tie up this match, a 25-15 second set victory. So yeah, I was happy to see Emery Pitcherosity come in as well as Isaiah Noguchi.
Yeah.
Those are going to be some players for this varsity team. They just came up this year. So I expect a lot of good things from them.
Yes, I do too.
And Noguchi is only a sophomore.
Yeah, he's quick, though. He's scrappy. He's quick. He has a good head for the game.
Yeah. As well as Emery Pitcherosity, yeah. Also a sophomore. So one person, player I haven't seen yet, who's I expect to contribute a lot, is Cyrus Burley.
Yeah, we haven't seen him yet in this ball game.
Yeah, he's an outstanding middle blocker, and he can hit with some pace too, boy.
Yeah, he can.
And you know, he's Steeler's brother, so they have a certain chemistry that I've noticed. I mentioned earlier about Lapella being a comedian, just number 13 for the Warriors, just seeing him doing his dance.
Yeah, he's hyping himself up for the third set here.
Yeah.
Like to see that. Everybody's enthusiastic. Came out here to play.
So congratulations to the JV team.
Yes.
They won their first KIF match of the season.
Straight sets.
Straight sets. A little different this year. In previous years, regardless of who won the first two sets, you would always play three sets for the JV game. Starting this year, however, whoever wins the first two sets, that's it. You only play a third set if you split the first two.
I kind of like that.
I like it too.
Yeah. We don't need a charity third set.
Although I do see the logic in earlier, but they're starting 30 minutes later. They used to start at 5 o'clock. But since they are starting at 5:30 now with the JV game, it kind of facilitates the speed of the game a little bit, so we're not here all night if we have a five-setter.
And speaking on the JV team, Ron, they're going to be good in the years to come. They have some huge players
some
on
height.
The team.
They got some height.
They got C.J. Jenkins.
Your son, Jenkins.
About 6'4". You got Tame, who's about 6'2", 6'3". Naki, 6', 6'1".
Yeah.
And another couple other players that are 6', 6'1". So they growing big in Kapaa.
I don't know what's in the water.
But they're gonna have a bright future.
I agree with that wholeheartedly. So it looks like Corin Pope, number 9, is going to start his third quarter.
He was kind of a spark when he did get some playing time.
Especially that first set.
Yeah.
He really contributed that first set.
He was quick off his feet and getting some blocks. All right, ready to start the third set here.
Yeah, waiting for the umpire to get up on his ladder.
On his perch.
Perch.
There he goes.
Alrighty, so starting the third set, serving will be Kapaa.
Looks like that'll be Steeler Burley. And if his father's in the stands, I'm sure he has a Steeler baseball football hat on.
Yep,
as customary.
Sure does.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, getting ready for the start of the third set here.
All right, here we go. See if the Warriors can have a little momentum into this third set.
Yeah, carry that momentum. Nice dig by Hunt.
Let me see. Oh, good save by Burley. Unfortunately, unable to keep it in the play.
Like the hustle. Looks like we have Isaac Myrie serving for the Red Raiders. Don't let him get hot on that serve. He can get 4 or 5 of those powerful jump serves down in a row.
Yeah.
That's his bread and butter.
It's all about the consistency, though.
Yeah.
And like that,
just like that. We saw him go on like a 4 or 5 point run, and then we've also seen him get a few out as well.
Yeah. So serving for the Warriors, Kyle Bouncett, who kind of stepped it up that second quarter with a couple kills.
Started to get hot.
And Appella.
Nice set to the middle.
Number one hitter.
And, Ron, we have an untraditional starting middle. He's not very tall, but he can get off the ground, and he has a lot of power behind his hips.
Yeah, he does. He's got that football player agility.
Yeah. Oh,
nice
great.
Nice dig. That's it.
Nice dig from Vito on the other side. Vito from the back row.
Another nice dig
by DeSalia Munden.
Felici Hunt gets it over, and Steeler Burley with the quick.
Bad set there for Hunt. Yeah, Hunt didn't have much to do with that one. That was a poor set.
Yeah. Did he go into the – oh, looks like that's a Warrior point.
Hey, we'll take it. We lucked out on that one. Kyle Bounce set to serve again.
Loving his shoes. Brian Brown with the quick dig. Felici.
Yes. Another point for the Raiders.
Yeah. Papa out of system there.
Yep.
So Brian Brown serving for the Red Raiders. A little bling in his ear.
Ooh. Lost the green serves hurt. Yeah.
That's what I mean. You got to watch. You can't go for the kill on every shot. You have to really watch where that ball is. And if it's not clear in the net, you got to make that adjustment.
Got a tie ball game here, 3-3. Over to Felici Hunt.
Oh, my God, what a kill by Felici Hunt.
That's what we needed. Yeah, hopefully that'll get him going. That was a beautiful kill there by Hunt,
number
15. Beautiful approach, beautiful set, and just a thunderous kill.
Finish, yeah. Lapella with the serve.
Felici got his hand on that one. Rod. Oh, Austin Green almost got that one down. Good dig there by Kyle.
Get it over.
Yeah, free ball for the Raiders. And a net ball by Valdez.
So DeSalia Munden will come in for Lapella. Definitely one of your defensive specialists.
Nice serve there by Hope Ho.
Could be a free ball.
Free ball for the Red Raiders.
Nice block. Yes. Burley. Oh,
nice.
It.
There you go.
It's a great kill.
Yeah, I think so far tonight, Kyle Bouncett is leading the team in kills. Austin Green back to serve.
Felici Hunt.
And yeah. That's a Red Raider ball there. Yeah, we've had our share of unforced errors tonight.
We're not really hurting ourselves with the serve, though, which I'm thankful for. So expect some heat to come our way from Valdez. They're coming right at us.
Nice serve. Felici Hunt.
Goes with the roll hit instead of the hard attack.
Coming back to Felici Hunt.
Oh.
Yeah, a little mishandle on the set there. I think he might have been a little bit out of position for that yeah, than a tempera.
I'm seeing him. His angle is coming really wide, and you want that from your outside hitter because he's right-handed. It gives him better angles to hit.
Beautiful serve there.
Nice, easy hit.
They weren't expecting that one.
So this third set is reminiscent of the first set, kind of back and forth so far.
Hopefully Felice Hunt can get on another roll like he did serving. I think he went 5, 6, 7 serves in a row. Nice serve.
Oh, great. One hitter. Raiders able to convert. Felice Hunt.
Austin Green. Good block by Vito.
Oh, my.
Ooh.
Great set by Austin Green over to Kyle Bouncet
for the kill.
That was excellent.
Kyle's starting to heat up a little bit, Rod.
Yeah, he is.
Felice Hunt again back to serve. We've had some success with this rotation.
Yeah, we have. Oh, they're going for the one.
Sheila Burley.
Oh, nice great save by Green. Hold hold with the back. Another great save by Burley.
Nice block by Vito.
Got ourselves a good rally, folks. Oh. Warriors should have a good one here. Yep, just like that. Yep. Pope. Very well played by both teams. Kapaa able to convert. And you called it, Felice Hunt.
Yeah, he
serves. Good things happen.
Definitely.
Got these boys on a roll.
Right, I am impressed with Vito's blocking ability for such a small guy. He's able to get up there and make some blocks.
Well, you mentioned his athleticism earlier. And that's going to be out.
Out of bounds.
So Warriors
starting to get a little roll here with Felice Hunt serving at the service line.
9-6.
Roddy, look at his serve. There's no frills, but there's a nice hard hit, downward trajectory, and it's quick off the hand.
Yes. And it's just like that.
Just like that.
And it barely covers the net. I mean, it's amazing how we're seeing it from this viewpoint.
Right.
This vantage. It's just like, this gets right over. It's so no nonsense. It's like, let me just put it up, get it over, and let's go.
Let's go. There it is again.
And it's going to be
out of bounds.
I wouldn't be surprised if the Raiders called a timeout
here. And there it is. We don't want this one to get away from them too much. The Red Raiders just a little bit out of sorts. Call the timeout to talk it over. They don't want it to get too out of control like the last set.
Yeah, Kapaa able to pull ahead 11-6. It was 6-6 at one point, but five straight points.
Yeah. Again, to that ball, even though it's a powerful hit by Felice, it does have a lot of movement on it, too.
Yeah. See if the Warriors can keep it going. Pope and Green hitting hands. And
you got Austin Green with the colorful way of Wade shoes.
Oh, yeah.
Like those.
Oh, you know about those.
Oh,
huh?
I like those. Old CJ's hit me up for a couple pairs of those.
Oh, a couple pairs, huh?
Well, the way his foot grows.
Oh, my gosh. All right. And
another nice serve. Hunt,
and he comes back with the ace.
Just like we talked about, Rod, you don't necessarily need a dramatic float serve or a powerful jump serve.
Yeah.
Just no nonsense.
And he's got a certain amount of pace on it. That's the thing. It's so deceptive.
Very deceptive.
Because he's not jumping, but he's still getting a lot of velocity on it.
Pope with a hand on it. Oh, and that's in.
Pope is on fire.
Curran Pope with the kill.
And I think I mentioned it first set. He talked to the coaches earlier and said, hey, you know, I'd like to try middle blocker. And they said, okay, let's see what this is. And they've been pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, it seems like a decent fit.
Oh, and that's going to be a Red Raider point. Isaiah LaCambra. So Christian Vito. It's been a while since the Red Raiders served.
Right back to Kyle.
Oh, my goodness. Yes. What a kill by Kyle. Bounce it.
If he gets a set like that.
Oh, my goodness.
It's a guaranteed point every time.
The height, the velocity,
the explosion.
The explosion, the placement. My goodness.
He's really starting to pick it up here.
Saw you Monday with the serve.
Like a free ball for the Warriors here. Another one to Kyle.
Oh, and he dumps it in there.
He gets another one.
And that's the thing. You know, you got to – he's keeping him honest.
Yeah, he is.
Because he's been so effective with his kills that you just assume that another kill's coming.
Right.
And then he just jumps it
over
the net.
Yeah, he's got to be approaching double digits in kills here. Started off slow, but he's really got a good rhythm going now.
Yeah, he does. So a little floor maintenance by the Red Raiders coming home. Keeping the floor dry.
Yes, indeed. Ooh, miss hit there by Potts.
And unable to grab that one. So Desaya Munden keeping it going for the Warriors as they lead 16-7 in this third set. Uncharacteristic unforced error.
Yeah.
Not too many of those for the Warriors.
We had a few in the first set and kind of cleaned that up.
Yep. And the ball gets sweaty. That's why they're constantly wiping the balls down and rotating the balls after every point.
Yes.
Oh, Kyle. Bounce it is on Fuego.
Another hammer for Kyle. He's feeling it right now, Rod.
Kyle is the hammer right now. Or as they say out here, hammer.
Hammer.
Steeler Burley. Great kill by Napella Mokuahi.
Don't let his thickness fool you.
Yeah.
He can get off the ground a little bit.
Yeah, he can. And he's one of your spiritual leaders on this team, too.
Yes, he is. Oh, boy, a little off balance there. Coming back to, Austin Green
with the kill. And the Warriors are fired up.
Yeah, they're feeling it right now.
19-8 lead.
Reminiscent of the second set here. Looks like we have Emery.
Emery coming in for Felici Hunt. I think I like the substitution. This is a good time to get him that exposure because we're going to need him definitely during the season.
Definitely.
To get this early exposure.
Holt Hoy.
Great dig.
Misjudged his jump there a little bit by Holt Ho.
Could be a free ball for Red Raiders.
Holt Ho.
Oh.
Holt Ho with the kill.
Warriors with the block, unfortunately, can't get it in.
Hopefully we can have Kapaw take care of business and put this one away. Finish it off in the next set. Got Isaac Myrie ready to serve again.
Kapaw with a nice, healthy 10-point lead. See if they can
nice
keep
serve.
It going. Oh, and bounce it.
That's another kill for Kyle. Bounce it.
So he's on the right side. You normally see him on the left side. So he'll serve now. Looks like we got a rotation. Oh, they're going to bring in Alex Andrade.
Yes.
And for Kyle, bounce it. So once again, this is something that you can do when you got a nice lead like that. As we get further into this KIF season, you're going to need all players to be able to contribute. Nice serve.
So if we got a, ooh.
Yeah. And Emery with the block.
It's like Red Raiders are a little bit out of system there, Rod.
Yeah, they are.
A little confusion going on that side.
And we got another sub in, so they're going to bring in Noguchi for Steeler Burley.
Just
I talked to you earlier. I like his setting ability.
Yeah, he's going to be a really great setter as he goes through with his high school volleyball career. Nice jump
great
serve there.
Serve. Oh, yeah. Great attempt.
Yeah. Oh! Let's see what we got here, Rod.
So because it came outside of the net and
yes.
not in between.
Yes.
So the ball actually landed in, but it's got to come in between
right.
the two antennas.
It was on the outside of the antenna there.
Great attempt, though. Oh, and then Andrade unable to.
Missed hit into the net. Those are killers. A few substitutions on both sides here.
And Kyle Balsett will come back in.
You know that was just for a quick a little breather there. He's been on fire. Keep feeding him. Got to feed the hot hitter. We've watched a lot of volleyball together. When you can keep feeding your hot hitter, just keep them going. Keep.
Oh, it's a beautiful thing.
It's a beautiful thing.
And the team gets fired up on it.
Austin Green, good block there by number 10.
Oh,
good dig there by number 6, Potts. And that is a
Kapaw point. Yep. So it looks like Hope will come in, as well as Alakai Sakai Giddens. I think this will be his first appearance.
Yes, it will.
I'm impressed how these players can come in.
Oh, ooh, off Green's head.
Yep. I was saying I'm really impressed how these guys can come in off the bench cold and serve and get the ball in.
Yeah.
Typically, they're coming off and
tight
and nervous. But that's a testament to the players for being ready and the coaches to make sure that the players are ready.
You got to stay limber when you're waiting to come in.
Yeah, and having the confidence in them.
Hold to serve. Nice. Ooh,
oh,
into the net.
Right into the net.
Got game point here for the Kapaw Warriors.
Aloha ball. Austin Green.
With the new way of Wade shoes.
Looks like a little strategy between bounce it and Green.
Mm-hmm. You'd love to see that.
Let's see where he serves to. Oh, I think he told him to serve to the new guy.
Yes.
Oh!
Oh, nice dive by Green.
Noguchi with the set to Green.
Oh! Nice dig. Number 2 with the...
Oh, and that'll be it.
That'll be the game. Third set to the Kapaw Warriors. Kapaw Warriors are up 2-1. Well, another pretty dominant set there, Rod, by the Kapaw Warriors.
Yeah, especially after that first set that they lost 26-24. They bounced back in the second, 25-15. And then this third set, another convincing 25-11.
Yeah. Dominating third set. They were close at the beginning, and then your Kapaw Warriors just pulled away.
Yep. So they need one more set.
Yes, sir. Maybe we can make that late dinner reservation tonight.
It is Friday night.
That's right. But I think they have a good flow going right now. They're feeding their setters. Kyle Bansett's getting hot, putting every ball into the ground.
Yes.
You got
said into the ground.
Into the ground.
Yeah, he's just drilling those balls.
You got Pope. He's active on the front lines there.
Love what I see from Pope. Yeah.
Some blocks. And then you got Green on the opposite side coming strong now.
Yeah, he started off a little inconsistent, but he's been picking it up now. As far as his hits, his kills, his serving has been consistent.
Yeah.
I'd say all the Warriors, the serving has been consistent for the most part.
It hasn't been too bad. And then you've had Napella, when he's been in the middle, he's been doing work.
Napella's been also, yep.
He's a big fella, but he can play. He can definitely play.
Yeah, these guys are standing on business today. So. So we got a minute and 19 seconds left before the start of the fourth quarter.
Yep, we have a four set coming up here. Hopefully this will be the last set of the night. The way they're playing, I don't think there's going to be any issues. They just got to keep the same mindset.
Yep.
Attack, attack, attack. Feed your hot hitters. Burley's been giving them some decent sets,
yeah,
man. And if you get a good set and you're a hitter, you feast on those.
Yeah. Even the Gucci, when he's come in,
yeah,
he's been effective with his sets as well. So we'll see if they can keep this momentum going. Once again, Kapa'a Warriors up 2-1 over the Kauai Red Raiders.
One competitive set and two not-so-competitive sets. Let's see if Red Raiders can figure a few things out, try and make this a little bit more competitive for the fourth set. It's going to be hard, though, because Kapa'a is in a real good groove right now, especially when they have Felici Hunt at the service line.
Yeah, Felici Hunt has definitely turned it on from that first set. He's picked it up.
Definitely has. All right, ladies and gentlemen, getting ready to start the fourth set here.
So, Warriors break their huddle.
Also, we want to thank Rod for supplying the music for the gym on all of the timeouts and intermissions.
Gotta keep the party going, Mix Master.
Yes, you are. Man of many talents. All right. Paul's eager. They're already on the floor. They want to finish this.
Yeah, I don't see the umpire up on the ladder yet. I guess he's at the bench having a conversation with the table.
Here he comes. Okay, Red Raiders are starting a different rotation here to start this fourth set. Got a few different players.
Well, I think the libero is going to come in for someone. Probably Caleb Schmeling, I'm thinking.
Yeah, that's...
But I don't know, number 10 is right there. We'll see if it's Valdez.
It looks like Valdez is waiting to come out, huh? All right. So checking out the rotations. Making sure everything is
in order, intact.
Yep. Here we go. Nope. Number 18, Caleb Schmeling, is going to be in the game.
Yep.
Let's see what this young man can do. Yeah. Maybe they're looking for a spark somewhere.
And sometimes you need that.
It
comes from, you never know. He's got the hot hand. He's feeling it. So our libero, Masaya Munden, will come in for Pope. I've really been impressed with Pope's game. And Pope's a junior.
Yeah. One more year.
Yeah.
Looks like we have Aaron Giuliano for the Red Raiders back to serve.
And here we go. Starting the fourth set.
Nice floater. Fell right in front of Anne-Marie.
Pitcher Rossetti.
That ball had a lot of movement on it, Rod.
It did. That's what we were talking about earlier. That float serve is so unpredictable.
Yeah.
So number 11 is in for the Warriors, Siron Burley. I expect a lot from him.
Yeah, heady player.
Oh, and the Warriors able to keep it in play. Great saves.
Yes.
Warriors got a free ball. Burley over to Green.
Warriors.
Ooh. Oh, the block. Oh.
Yeah. A nice hammer there by Cameron Holt-Hole.
Siron Burley was able to get his hands on it. I think it was might have been a double hit, though.
Yeah, it was. Definitely a double hit. Giuliano back to serve again for the Red Raiders. That was out.
And heads up play by pitcher Rossity by not hitting that.
He thought about it for a second.
Yeah, he did think about it. It was right there. So Kyle Bouncett, he's serving for the Warriors. He's been steady so far.
You'd expect Kyle Bouncett to have a devastating jump serve, but he just gets the ball over and gets into position.
And that's all you need. And you know, a lot of these – I've seen players before in past years where they're trying to – everybody's doing jump serves, and they don't even have a 50% success rate doing it.
Right.
But it's the ego, it's the machismo, I gotta hit the ball as hard as I can. It doesn't count if you can't get the ball in.
Right. Sometimes it's better just to get into your offensive scheme.
And it's been working for the Warriors. So for the Red Raiders, Caleb Schmeling.
Emery.
Pitcher Rossity gets blocked. Oh, hit the net?
No,
looks like Cameron Holt-Ho hit the net.
Yes, he did.
So that'll be Warrior ball. And Pope will come in for the libero. Visalia Munden.
And Potts in for the Red Raiders.
And that's Burley's first serve of the game. And Emory pitcher Rossity with the kill.
I think that's his first kill of the season, Ron.
And as I mentioned earlier, how these players come off the bench cold and they serve. Mm-hmm. Looks like we have a little discussion now.
Got another issue here on the court between the referees.
Oh, they're going to give the ball to the Red Raiders.
Okay.
I think they're going to say it was four hits.
All righty, we have Brian Brown back to serve for the Red Raiders.
Now on a block, you are allowed to hit the ball four times. That block doesn't count as a hit, so I'm not sure what happened right there. Oh, Emery with the kill.
Nice.
So that'll be
there.
His first official kill. Then.
Yeah.
I guess they robbed him of the last one.
Nice attempt there by Potts, number six with the Red Raiders. He's all over the floor. He's Mr. Energy.
So Austin Green will be serving it up for the Warriors. And the Raiders.
Nice kill there by Lacombra. Nice setup, nice explosion off the ground. That was just an overall nice play there by number seven for the Raiders Warriors.
So Myrie will come back in for Giuliano. Haven't seen Myrie in a minute.
No. And like you said, we'll see if he's cold or not. Hasn't played for a minute.
And Holt-Ho with that jump serve right into the net.
Yeah, he's had a couple of those tonight, Ron.
So Emery, pitcher Rossity will get a chance to serve for the Warriors.
First serve of the year. Got a free ball for the Warriors.
Not sure about that set right there.
I think there might have been a miscommunication there.
It looked like the speed of a one, but it went out to the outside hitter.
Mm-hmm.
A little confused on that one.
A Beautiful serve there by number 10.
Green with the roll hit.
Free ball for the Warriors. Bam.
Man.
Bounce it.
Again.
With a devastating kill.
We just got to keep feeding and feeding and feeding him. He's the hot man right now.
Just keep feeding him.
Just let him dominate. Get him the ball.
So Desaya Munden. Hold her with the back serve.
Well, we got a whistle here. Kapal point. It's about this time in the sets, Rod, where Kapal started to pull away. But we do have a different lineup in there right now. Okay, that'll be a point for the
Red Raiders.
Raiders. I think both teams are a little bit out of system right now, Ron.
A little bit. As LeCambra will serve for the Red Raiders. And a little long. So Kapa ties it up. Once again, another unforced error. So Siren Burley will come in for Curran Polk. Have a 7-7 tie.
Yeah, it looks like Kapaz just trying to get some other players in there and get them a little bit of time on the court tonight, Rod. And like you said, we're going to need everybody for KIF.
Well, I will say this. Kapaz's team is very deep.
Yes, they are.
And the Raiders with the kill.
But you know, as my philosophy, I like to get the lead a little bit before we start making some of these early substitutions, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but, you know, with the players that are on the court right now, I don't see it as a drop-off, quite honestly.
Yeah.
I mean, Pitcherosity and Burley, Siren Burley, definitely can bring it. So
chemistry's a bit off right now, though.
Yeah, that's the key, the chemistry.
Nice dig by Emery.
Oh. And Austin Green.
He was going for that angle.
It's all about the timing.
Mm-hmm.
Giuliano. Serving for the Red Raiders. It's a bounce set.
Right back to him. That should be Kapal ball. Yes, it is. Net violation. Red Raiders. That was a pretty good net violation. When you see the net shake that much, somebody's in the net.
I tell you what, it's hard to tell from my vantage point, and I don't profess to be a volleyball specialist by any means, and bounce set is the unforced error.
Yes.
Now, that's his Achilles heel, and that was last year. Sometimes it'll be certain moments of the game or the match, and he'll hit an errant serve. You don't know where it comes from.
Yeah, that's a couple serving errors today, Rod. We got number 6, Potts, back to serve.
And that'll be Warrior ball with a Burley connection.
Brother to brother.
So Pope will come in for Desaya Munden once again. Very formidable front line right now. And Burley unable to get the ball in.
Yes.
Is that jump serve?
He
can get it in, but unfortunately was unable to convert. So Red Raiders maintaining a 2-point lead right now. Brian Brown serving.
Oh, an interesting serve there from Brown. Nice hit by Green.
Nice hit.
Back to Green just to get it over.
Burley over to, oh.
Yeah, a little wide on that set.
Teacher Rossity did a good job of getting that ball in.
Yeah, he did.
Burley with the set to Green. Oh, and Green into the net.
Yeah, he's had a couple of those net balls. I like his approach. I like his explosion off the ground. He'll start getting them on the other side.
Yeah, once again, if the ball is not high, set high enough.
Right, and he likes it high. He likes
a
high set.
He does like it hot, yeah. But that's up to the player to adjust wherever the ball is.
Mm-hmm. I think that was blocked out of bounds.
Yeah, yeah, it looks like they blocked it, but it was out. And they'll talk about it.
We have Austin Green back to serve. If they do, in fact, get the point.
And it'll still be Warrior ball.
Got a lot of talking amongst the refs tonight, Rod.
You know what? And I don't mind that. If you have any questions about something, just discuss it and figure it out and make sure you get it right.
We want the right call.
So now, ref is talking to Kapaz, bitch.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
Austin Green to serve.
And Brian Brown with the unforced error.
Yeah, I think that was a case. He should have just got the ball over the net.
Over, yeah. There is, like I mentioned, there's definitely a degree of difficulty going for a kill from the back row.
Yes.
Some players are really effective at it. It takes a lot of skill.
Bad set to hold.
And you see how he adjusted, though.
Yeah.
Oh. And Emery Pitcherosity just outside.
I think we got a net violation, though, on the Raiders.
Oh, did we?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I think we got a Red Raider net violation.
Well, 12-12. Warriors tied it up.
Austin Green still serving.
Giuliano sets it. Bumps it. Back
Green.
Set.
Going back to Emery. Yes, it is. Nice angle there.
Great
by Emery. Beautiful angle on that attack by Emery.
And it's a great save by the
yep.
Raiders, but unable to keep it in the play.
I think Emery, if he would have went straight up, he would have been blocked. He picked a perfect angle to make that kill.
Austin Greens. 13-12 lead Warriors. Oh, that was a great kill by Zayden Valdez.
Valdez very excited about that kill.
Yeah, that was a nice one. Haven't seen too many ones from the
mm-hmm.
Raiders as far as the set
yep.
tempo. Cameron Ho-Ho for the Red Raiders. And
another powerful jump server here, Ho-Ho.
And Miles Green will come in for Austin Green.
Miscommunication there with the Warriors.
Yep. It's going to be Red Raider ball. Point. So Ho-Ho still serving for the Red Raiders as they have a 1-point lead, 14-13.
Nice serve.
And once again, they get another quick one-hitter.
Valdez is starting to feel himself a little bit.
So I think they got to recognize that they're going to hit Valdez with that one as a middle blocker. Very effective because he can spring up
yeah,
the floor.
Yeah, he's not tall, but he has a tremendous jumping ability.
Great serve by Ho-Ho.
Look for a timeout here, Rod.
Yeah.
And right on cue, timeout. The Paul Warriors.
And I like this timeout. It's not not too much of a substantial lead.
Yeah, but you got to stop that momentum right now. It looks like Red Raiders have all the momentum, and you want to try and stifle that a little bit if you can.
Yep.
close enough for the Warriors to do a little bit of damage. You don't want to let it get too out of control. And I like this timeout by coaching staff.
Yeah, very timely timeout, if you will, by the Warriors. So,
especially in this fourth set, because we can put it away here, so we don't want to let them get up that much.
Yeah, you like to get it done in four sets, because that fifth set is only 15 points, and
yeah.
It's all about whoever starts off with the most momentum.
Right.
And
anything
can carry
happen.
You.
Yes, it can. We've seen it happen.
Yeah, at that point, it's anyone's match, so. Hold. We'll see if coaching staff of the Warriors were able to ice him.
Nice
back with
serve.
A good serve. Pitcherosity.
Good block there.
Bounce set.
Boom. Lucky to get that one over the net, Ron.
Free ball for Kapaw. See if they can capitalize on it. Pitcherosity with
nice.
The kill. That's what the Warriors needed.
They needed
Emery
that.
Coming through for the Warriors. And he'll serve now. That's what I was saying earlier. With these players on the floor, it's not really a drop-off.
Mm-hmm.
Good save, and Brian Brown rolls it right into the net.
We've seen that two or three times
now.
From Brown, yeah.
Just a little too nonchalant with that. And then Pitcherosity can serve. Cameron Holdho. Oh, great
yes.
save by DeSalia Munden.
Yes.
Kyle bounce it.
Nice block by Valdez.
Gonna be a free ball. Oh, yep. Miles Green gets it over to Burley. And Kyle bounce it. Just rolls.
Oh. A little momentum here.
Yep. Not hard, but very effective.
Mm-hmm. We have a quick substitution here for the Red Raiders.
So Schmeling will be coming back in.
Caleb Schmeling
for Potts. So Valdez, we've seen him.
Yeah, he's
hit some high velocity serves.
He's starting to get hot too. He's been very active at the net.
Man. Oh, hits it right into the net.
Yeah, that was a miss hit right directly off the hand. I saw that a mile away coming. That just went off the right side of his hand.
So Siren Burley enters the game once again. For the Warriors as DeSalia Munden serves it up. Down by one.
We have a free ball here for the Warriors.
Let's see if they can capitalize. Oh!
Out.
Burley to Burley and Siren unable to get that ball in between the lines. 18-16. Red Raiders.
See what we can do with this. There it is. I
oh.
told you.
Kyle.
I knew he was coming with the thunder with that
with
one. He got a
yeah.
decent set. Nice approach. Good explosion off the ground.
All he needs is a good set. He'll take care of the rest.
He will. I would have bet the farm that was going to be a point.
So you got Steeler Burley. He's serving for the Warriors. Oh, nice block by Miles.
Yes.
And into the net by Isaiah LaCambra. So the Warriors able to tie it up at 18.
Yeah. And Rod, we haven't seen Christian Vito for quite a while.
That is correct.
He had some success early on in the game.
Burley gets it in. Holdho goes out to Brian Brown.
Ooh.
Oh, great save by the Warriors.
Beautiful save.
Oh.
It's a kill for Brian Brown.
Yep, hits it off of Miles Green.
Brian Brown's trying to get going. He's had a pretty rough night tonight.
For him, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Have Aaron Giuliano back to serve for the Red Raiders.
Got a close game here, 19-18.
That was in.
Great serve by Giuliano.
Yes.
Warriors just kind of parted the Red Sea for him. You got to get that.
They did.
I mean, at a certain point, if the ball is close, you got to go for it.
Yeah.
20-18, Red Raiders of this fourth set.
Ooh, shank by Emery. A free ball here for the Red Raiders coming up, Rob.
Oh, great block by Siren Burley.
Brian Brown.
Great dig by Bounce It.
Green. Out of bounds.
Oh, was it tipped? It looks like it's...
Oh, they're saying, are they signaling the tip? Yes, they are. We will take it.
20-19. Kyle Bounce It. Last serve. He hit it out. See if he can...
Just get it. Keep it in play.
There we go. Free ball for the Warriors. See if they can capitalize. Oh, no. Bounce It.
Ah. Oh,
right into the net. And that was one that the Warriors needed. They were unable to capitalize. They had a free ball there.
Valdez back in for the Red Raiders. He's been their spark plug.
A little surprised that the Burleys missed the communication on that. They're really typically have really good chemistry. Pitcherosity gets stuffed.
Beautiful block by Ho-Ho.
Way to adjust by Emery. That wasn't the best set.
Brian Brown.
And.
He brings it. Oh. All right.
They're saying tip.
Yeah, I thought there was a tip by Kapaa on that one, Rod. We'll take the point, but I think there might have been a tip. I had a pretty good view. We don't have our replay tonight.
And even if we did, it's not allowed.
Well, it's allowed for us, so we know. We just want to know. But Kapaa gets a lucky one there. We'll take it. Maybe it'll shift this momentum a little bit.
See if they can capitalize.
Burley back to serve. Good block by Pope. Hold. Oh, that might have been going out of bounds.
Oh, great save by Bounce It to see if they can get it over. And Steeler able to keep it in.
Brian Brown.
Great. Oh, and the Red Raiders able to convert on a great rally.
Valdez is hyped. He's keeping him in the game right now, Rod.
Yeah, he is. So Desalia Munden will come in for Siler Burley. I'm sorry, Siren.
Siren, yes.
Siren. So Brian Brown.
Back to serve.
Oh, Curry.
Pope. Pope with the kill. Good hustle, though, by the Red Raiders. They almost were able to grab that one.
Yeah, they did. So Miles Green is going to stay in the game, and he's going to serve.
Like that name. That's an old school name, Miles Green.
Definitely love his enthusiasm.
Mm-hmm. Let's get this ball over the net and get into your. There we go. Nice serve.
Good serve. Oh, and the Warriors.
Yes.
Able to convert.
Time out. Red Raiders. Thank you. And we have Napella dancing as usual over there on the Kapa side.
Yeah, if Napella likes a song, he's going to dance.
Love the enthusiasm. Guys are truly having fun out there.
That's what it's all about. Mm-hmm. And that's what actually drew me to the sport. I've watched teams play, and the right. team will be down, but they're still smiling. They're still having a great time.
It's a fun sport to watch.
It really is. And super exciting.
It definitely. Especially when your kids are in the sport, too. That makes it a little more interesting.
Makes it stressful, too.
Yes, it does. And you all know out there, my daughter, Olivia Jenkins, she's a hammer.
Looking forward to her having another recovery and coming back.
Another all-star season for her.
All right, 22-22. And an emphatic shot by Zayden Valdez.
Valdez is, he's emotional.
He is emotional, and he brings the heat with his kills.
And that intensity. I love that intensity.
So it looks like they haven't adjusted the score yet. I thought it was 22-24. Should be 23-22.
Should be 23. We've had issues with the scoreboard all night tonight. And like you said, these are new scoreboards, so we're trying to figure out the bugs.
Yeah, you would think you wouldn't have any with brand new scoreboards.
You would think. New scoreboards in an old building. I don't know if two of them.
All right, now they got it squared away. 23-22.
Hold the serve. Into the net.
Jump serve into the net.
He is pretty consistent, though, with that jump serve, Holt-Ho.
He is, but, you know.
Not there, yeah.
Yeah. So Alex Ograde will come in for Emery Pichurasuti to serve.
Oh, looked like a miss hit by Potts.
It was. So it looks like Aloha ball coming up. For the Warriors.
Timeout, Red Raiders. They want to talk about it. Let's see if we can finish this off.
Kapa'a over the Kauai Red Raiders. Can they close out the set and close out the match? That is the question.
That is the question. I'm gonna go out on a limb. I think it ends here, Rod.
You think so?
I know you don't like when I do that, but I think it ends here.
All right, here we go.
I got the faith. Here we go. Ready to serve for the Warriors. I'd go right back to Potts with this ball, Rod. He's mishandled a couple of them tonight.
And he went to Potts.
And here it is.
Set.
Ball game. No.
Not yet.
Good save.
Roll hit.
Here we go. Let's get a good set. Nice block
there.
Try
to get the quick one. I would end it with bounce it. Here we go.
That's
how you end it. That's how you end it.
Ball game. Kapa Warriors with the sweep. Win the game 25-23. Will Rod, that was an exciting first game of the KIF season.
We will definitely take that. 25-23, the final set. So for those of you at home, first set, Kauai won 26-24, followed up by Kapa'a sweeping the next three, 25-15, 25-11, and 25-23.
Excellent start to the season.
Excellent start to the season. And as is customary,
the two teams will, after they congratulate each other, they will line up and sing the school alma mater.
Have the cheerleaders involved for this as well.
Very impressive first match by the Kapaa Warriors.
Definitely. Started out a little slow, a little rough. They worked out a few of the kinks and had a nice next three sets. Even though this last one was a close rod, it's still a good win.
Yep, definitely a good win. So the next game will actually be on the road against Waimea next Tuesday.
Yeah, that should be a heck of a game.
Every game this year, all the games will be either on a Tuesday or Friday, with the exception of the last game of the season, and that'll actually be on a Saturday.
Saturday, right.
And that'll be the senior night for the volleyball players.
And how many seniors do we have this year, Rod?
We have six seniors.
Okay, quite a few seniors.
Yeah. Kyle Bouncett, Saxon Kimball, Alakai Sakai Giddens, Steeler Burley, Miles Green, and Napella Mokuahi. So you got a nice balance and a nice mix.
Yeah, definitely do.
As you see the Kapaa Warriors singing their school alma mater with the cheerleaders backing them up.
Love to see the school pride.
Oh, yeah, definitely. So we want to give a big shout-out to the Kapaa High Media for putting on this presentation.
Yeah, we couldn't do this without them.
Able to get the game to the folks that couldn't make it out in person. I know some people around the country watching it. Shout-out to Neilani Green in L.A. I know she's watching her younger brother do his thing.
All right.
Congratulations, Kapaa Warriors, way to start the season. Any final comments before we wrap it up?
Just it was a great game. This is pretty much what we expected, and get used to the parity in the league. There's going to be some great games this year.
I'm excited about this season, and if we can just keep this momentum going.
Rod, even though this is a volleyball game, we have to end
don't
the game
it.
Like we usually end the game, our basketball games.
Start it off.
Go Lakers.
Go Bulls.
Everybody have a great evening.
Have a great night, folks. Aloha.